The reason that I've started with this trial is that while traveling all over the world, I see the problems that people have if they want to grow vegetables or if they want to grow food. They have little capital, they have many times not even energy for pumps, there's a water problem, they cannot even pay the fertilizers. So if we can develop a method to grow vegetables with very little water, without using energy and without using fertilizers, then we actually can help poor farmers to still produce sufficient food for the people in the cities. There are about 300 million poor farmers in the world that have a problem to grow in the modern way with hydroponics. If you want to grow with drip irrigation, you need to dig a well, and a well costs you $5,000. You need electricity for the pump, which is also very expensive. So you cannot grow vegetables on a small scale if you want to do that with drip irrigation. With this method, any family can buy 5 or 10 boxes and then produce food even for their own use. What I actually hope is that when I've proved that this principle of growing is working well, that governments or NGOs will develop instruments, microcredit instruments, for poor farmers so that they are able to buy the Groasis Waterboxx and produce their food with it in a very efficient and cheap way.
We are now harvesting cucumbers. You have to pick the biggest one out of the cucumbers and cut it with a knife, just on the stem, like this. And then you remove the flower, because the flower is start to rot. The cucumber is giving some juice here, and it's sticky. So you have to put every cucumber the same way up.
Here we see hot pepper plants. These pepper plants on the left side have not been treated with mycorrhizal fungi. On the right side, they have. When we take soil samples in the middle of the water box, and we take 100 cubic centimeter of ground of soil, and we determine how many root development is in that sample, then we find that the untreated plants have about 25% of root development compared to the mycorrhizal plants on the right side. The non-treated plants, they only do not form less roots. Also, the root system is growing in a different way. It's more superficial in the soil. And this has also a reflection on the production. The mycorrhizal plants, they form roots much more deeper. They take up more nutrients and water, and therefore they start to produce one bunch earlier than the non-treated plants.
How do you bring the minerals, the food that the plants need, to the plant?
We have to cut off the leaves of the tomato plant. And you see this bubble here? This is the breaking point.